One.
My Lord would see that Article 51 deals with a stage where the elections are being conducted, elections, it deals with the elections, it deals with the seats which are to be filled. Now, during the process, once the seats get filled, then they become members of the houses. So in the constitutional flow, a scheme of things, you start with 51 and then when you proceed, you are past 51 and the returned candidates are declared as such, they are administered oaths of the offices, they become members. So the interface is quite clear, sir, as far as my submission goes.
General, it seems to me that perhaps you have reversed the sequence. I think the operative presumption of the constitution is that in any house or election assembly, no seat, reserved or otherwise, will be left vacant. That is the basis on which the constitution proceeds, to which, for example, Article 222(4) is an exception, that you must leave it vacant. Now, that presumption proceeds also on other presumptions. As my learned colleague Justice Masood Ali Shah pointed out, that the number of independents will be low. As you yourself said yesterday, that if there is a very, very large number of independents returned, there is something dysfunctional, something has gone out of kilter. Right? You said that yesterday.
My precise words were that people have then rejected the political parties.
In the sense that we have a parliamentary democracy based on political parties.
Yeah.
So once you accept that as the basis of the constitutional framework insofar as we are presently concerned, then other things follow, then other clauses and provisions make sense. But here the very large number of independents, which you say is resulting in a vacancy of the reserved seats and therefore the excess seats, as it were, go to the political parties and so on. It seems to me that that begs the question, where did that very large number of independents come from? Were they independents returned by the people, or were they independents, with all due respect to the Election Commission, created by the Election Commission on its faulty understanding of the Constitution and in particular the judgment of the Supreme Court, which upheld their order? They said it meant this. It didn't say this, it didn't mean this at all. So you see, when we are in this realm, if this is the correct position, that this whole problem or issue is arising out of errors made by the Election Commission, then surely it is the, or is it not, the duty of the court, the Supreme Court, to the extent that it is able to do that, to correct that error, to rectify the problem, and if there are alternate pathways available, legally available, to choose the one that results in the error being rectified, and either for that problem, quote unquote, of reserved seats, the excess reserved seats going to political parties who are not really entitled to that because that tips the balance, that problem being disappeared because the reserved seats go to some political party to which is entitled, or maybe keeping the resultant vacancies to a minimum. I mean, seems to me surely that is the correct way to interpret and apply the Constitution.
My Lord.
Rather than just saying, no, the seats cannot lie vacant. No, I am sorry, I don't, with all due respect, look at it that way. I think the Constitution assumes that the seats will not lie vacant, and therefore, in terms of 22.4, expressly creates a situation where the Constitution says, look, this is the working basis of the Constitution, but here the seat must lie vacant. Surely that's the better and more correct approach.
My Lord, I had begun my submissions by yesterday by stating that these reserve seats under 51(6) are to bring in women in such large numbers to the assemblies. It is for their empowerment. and the tool is the political party, or the vehicle is the, or in the engine is the political party, and then there is a system which is provided, and that system excludes independence. So this is the flow.
But you see, it now seems to me, just looking at jo aap abhi baat kar rahe hain, but then why have the system of proportional representation? Because it seems to me that when a general election especially takes place and general seats are contested by political parties, the mandate of the people is returned on that basis. Now you tip the balance. If you just take it up proportionally, right, in terms of the reserved seats, a political party wins 30% seats, it gets, leaving aside the proviso for a moment, it gets 30% of the reserved seat, another one wins one seat, so it gets nothing, and so on and so forth. That does not upset the mandate of the people. But if you, the approach that you take, that this is for this purpose, and therefore the seats cannot be left open, that actually tips the electoral mandate.
What you have before you, my lord, and also what, when you look at 51-60, and the way I look at it is that it requires exclusion of independence. I'm sure my lord would appreciate that, that independents have to be excluded and so on. Now, the only question or the observation which has come thus far is that such a large number of independents have returned. So what do we do about that situation? I'll come to that. But I've just shown you in 2008, there were about 20, more than 20% in Balochistan returned independents. Now, surely those 10 independents also had people's mandate. Yeah,
if you I don't know, is it anybody's case before
us? Yes, I'm going to come to that.
You don't know what I'm going to ask. Is it anyone's case before us that the seats should remain vacant? I've not heard that from that side.
This side
is saying they should come to me. The other political parties are saying that they should come to them, but it's nobody's case.
Yes.
Why are we exploring something which nobody is pleading?
Yes, and Mr. Siddiqui,
because,
if I recall,
the general principle of cases before the Supreme Court is you should only adjudicate matters which come before the Supreme Court. So why are we going into, why are you spending so much time on the seats can't be left vacant? Nobody wants the seats to be left vacant.
And I believe Mr. Siddiqui did take a position on this when a question was asked, and he said that they can't be left vacant, if I recall it correctly. So clearly there was no
position taken on
that.
No, Mr. Siddiqui's whole case is they should come to the Sunita Council. It's
yes.
As simple as that. Nothing complicated
about this.
This
is the last part where I will address this.
Achha,
what can and cannot
be
done.
If we have simple proportional representation, then one way it was very easy. जितने ये सारे क्लॉजेस की जरूरत ही नहीं थी, एक शिक होती, 5% वोट मिले तो आपको वो इतने मिल जाएंगे ऑटोमेटिकली, आपको किसी को सोचने की जरूरत ही नहीं है, टक करके कर दें. तो ये पॉलिटिकल पार्टी ये वगैरह इसमें कोई लिखने की जरूरत नहीं थी. जिस पॉलिटिकल पार्टी को जितने सीट मिले बस उसको आप दे दें इलेक्शन में,
पॉपुलर वोट की बेसिस
नहीं. वो तो एक बहुत सिंपल सी बात लिख देते हैं आइन वाले. मैं बार बार इसीलिए आइन कि जो तहरीर है पत, वो क्यों उन्हें किया, गलत किया, कैसे किया, क्यों नहीं उन्हें सोचा कि ऐसा सिचुएशन डेवलप हो सकता था, ये वो जाने, हमारा काम नहीं है.
ये आखिर मेरा है. आई एम ऑन माय सेकंड लास्ट सबमिशन, बट द लास्ट सबमिशन इज प्रिसाइसली दिस. इफ आई मे नाउ प्रोसीड विद माय सेकंड लास्ट,
थोड़ा सा स्पीड करें
जी. माय लॉर्ड, नाउ लुकिंग एट द प्रोविजो टू क्लॉज डी और पैराग्राफ डी. There are two things. I have to reread it for the purpose of this submission.
अभी बार बार वही चीज़ पढ़ रहे हैं आप, क्या फायदा?
मैं सिर्फ एक चीज़ यहाँ पे बस दिखाना चाहता हूँ कि the independent returned candidates or candidates who may duly join a political party, they add on to the tally. Now here the independent returned candidate is joining a political party. After joining this political party, he becomes a member of that political party. And when he becomes a member of that political party, on account of such membership, and after oath having been administered to him, he must necessarily become member of parliamentary party of that party. If I may take your lordships to clause 2 of article 63A, I'll first read it out and then I'll make my submission. Clause 2 of Article 63A, sir. A member of a house shall be deemed to be a member of a parliamentary party if he, comma, having been elected as a candidate or nominee of a political party which constitutes the parliamentary party in the house. Take a pause here, sir.
Sorry, I missed it.
Clause 2 of Article 63A, sir.
63A. Achha, okay, I was reading 63A.
I'd reread it. A member of a house shall be deemed to be a member of a parliamentary party if he, having been elected as a candidate or nominee of a political party which constitutes the parliamentary party in the house. A pause here. So,
तो इसका मतलब ये हुआ कि पॉलिटिकल पार्टी पार्लियामेंट में नहीं होती, पॉलिटिकल पार्टी के जो नॉमिनेटेड कैंडिडेट्स होते हैं वो होते हैं और उनकी अपनी पार्लियामानी पार्टी होती है,
मैं इसको
पॉलिटिकल पार्टी से अलग होती है।
मैं नहीं, मैं अभी मैं उस पॉइंट पे नहीं, मैं यहाँ पे तो सिर्फ ये सबमिट कर रहा हूँ कि फॉर अ पॉलिटिकल पार्टी टू हैव अ पार्लियामेंट्री पार्टी इन द हाउस इट्स कैंडिडेट्स और नॉमिनीज मस्ट हैव succeeded in the elections to constitute that parliamentary party. Now, if I may read the language after. Or, having been elected otherwise than as a candidate or nominee of a political party, now this is independent, has become a member of such parliamentary party after such elections. The effect of this is that an independent returned candidate who becomes a member can only join such parliamentary party of a political party whose at least one member, one candidate or nominee must have succeeded in the elections to constitute that parliamentary party.
It's after the constitution of the parliamentary party.
That is when he takes oath and becomes a member of the house.
But that at that point in time, the joining of that independent with that political party is entirely irrelevant for purposes of
main usi pe hi baat raha hu sir. Now when you're looking at
it's entirely irrelevant.
Now my proceedings, now let me proceed with my submissions here.
Prior to all of
I just now want to make a submission.
Idhar hi sawal aa jata hai na, isme zara clear kar de, because I couldn't find the provision. How does a party become a parliamentary party? Which provision governs that?
My lord, parliamentary party is not defined in the constitution. 63A is a provision which deals with parliamentary party, and clause 2 is the clause which explains what will be a parliamentary party, and that's about it.
I mean, in the rules of business of the parliament or wherever, I mean, how do we, what's the act? I mean, when does it become a parliamentary party?
It flows from here. So anyone who has returned as a candidate or nominee on a political party's ticket will become a member of parliamentary party of that party, or will constitute a parliamentary party of that
party.
And when an independent wants to join a parliamentary party, he has to join such parliamentary party. In other words, independents cannot form a parliamentary party. There can't be any independent parliamentary bloc.
दोबारा पढ़ लेना, दोबारा अगर उसको पढ़ लें. Having been elected as a candidate or nominee of political party,
yes.
फिर हम उसमें चले जाएंगे 66 में सर्टिफिकेट पे.
Yes, मैं आपको ला रहा
हूँ सर्टिफिकेट वाला बंदा.
I'm taking you back there. मैं यहाँ पे सिर्फ ये पॉइंट आपको बता रहा था. एक पॉइंट वो ये कि पार्लियामेंट्री पार्टी तो होगी वो जो फर्स्ट पार्ट है. इंडिपेंडेंट ने इसी पार्लियामेंट्री पार्टी को ज्वाइन करना है जिसका कोई कैंडिडेट या नॉमिनी जीत के आया हो. नाउ वी टेक गो बैक टू क्लॉज पैराग्राफ डी, प्रोवाइज पैराग्राफ डी.
Sorry, here is something new for me. The political party automatically transforms into, if let's rephrase it, if there are some elected people of a political party in the National Assembly, they don't have to do anything. They automatically transform into a
parliamentary party.
Is this correct?
Yes.
So the political party inside the parliament is referred to as the
parliamentary party of that political party, and the independent.
Why the two distinctions? Yeah, why can't we just stick with political party? Yeah, what was the reason for
this? The purposes of 63A, sir. Parliamentary party becomes relevant as opposed to political party because